I promise that you'll never find another like me.
To see that Jonathan Pednault has resigned as the deputy leader of the Green Party of Canada today. He was working with Elizabeth May for the last couple of years, and he's a remarkable man from all accounts, a human rights leader, worked in conflict zones throughout the world. I admire him very much. I wish him all the success in whatever he's doing next. But I can't help but notice that he's leaving a gaping hole in the Green Party. And I would love to talk to Mrs. May, about perhaps reshaping that party into something with a whole lot of horsepower under the hood. Something that can win elections. You know, I call it the Dark Green Independence. And that name was inspired by the way the Green Party does not whip votes. That's always, to me, been the secret sauce of the party. The only problem has been there's not been enough members of parliament who were green for it to really matter. I think as the Dark Green Independents, we could attract some very strong candidates, and with some small modifications to the platform, to capture people's imagination with something something maybe shocking, but entirely predictable if you've read my novel. Of course, the universal basic income is something near and dear to my heart. I would desperately love to put the pedal to the metal on that.